Hi there! In this video, we are going to start exploring Dataverse and the app that we are going to build throughout this example. Dataverse, it's a powerful tool for managing and storing data that's inside the Power Platform. As we can see, even in the documentation of Microsoft, Dataverse is highly linked to all of these components of the platform. For example, all your flows, informations, Power Pages, connectors, environment variables, everything you use inside Power Apps and the environment is stored in Dataverse. Everything relies on Dataverse. So we can say that's a very robust structure. Let's get started by looking at the Dataverse interface, see what it is, and where you can find it. As you can see here, I'm on my make.powerapps.com. That's where we develop our apps. We go to apps and build our canvas apps, our model-driven apps connected to our data sources, right? And here we have tables. So I'm on an environment that has a Dataverse enabled on it. And if I go to tables, I see several tables in here. These are already the Dataverse tables. Everything has a table. For example, Excel has tables. SharePoint has lists. That's like a table. Other databases are based on tables, and the same for Dataverse. When we talk about tables, we have both standards and custom tables. Standard tables are the tables predefined by the system. Dataverse already has a lot of tables on it. As we can see here, some of these tables already existed when the environment was ready to be used, when it was a very new environment. And some tables were created by me on another examples. So for example, we have here a custom table that I created that's called inventory or inventory part or location that I used to create an inventory app during my studies. See, once I clicked on it, I can see that it has data on it. Going back to, we are going to create that in the next videos, so don't worry. This is just a simple explanation about what's Dataverse and where you find it. If you don't see tables here, it means you don't have a Dataverse on these environments. I'm assuming you already have an account that has Dataverse and Power Apps, so we can start building it. Now, we can also see that we have several tables here. For example, account, that's one table we are going to use later in this series. Or contact, that's another table that stores contacts. Accounts stores, for example, companies or clients. And we have several tables in here that most of the times I don't use because I create custom applications, but they are already here to use. For example, the account table has a lot of columns that we can use to store account information. This one is empty because I didn't store any data, but if we go to columns, since tables have columns, we can see that we have several columns already predefined for the accounts. For example, address, account number, rating, a lot of fields for the address, emails, and so on. So based on the use of the tables during the years, Microsoft already let this table here for us to use. So we don't need to create all these fields and we don't need to use all of them. Also, for example, let's see the contacts table that stores contacts. It could be a contact from your customer or an internal contact or also a supplier. So let me click on it and let's see what we have. As you can see here in this table, we have people's information. We have names, last name, emails, then the combination of first name and last name gives us the full name. We can also associate to a company, that's in this case is the accounts table, and we have 216 other columns. We have a lot of columns. If we go to columns, we can also see those columns. Also, we have address, emails, and other informations that are here. We don't need to use all of them, but they are here to use, and those are usually information for people. Okay, and this table we are going to use also in our examples later. One thing that we are going to see that's to manage and deploy these tables effectively, we are going to use solutions. We are going to create a solution that allows us to package our tables and other components such as apps, flows, and make it easier to transfer between environments. If we have, for example, test or developer environments, the solutions is also found in the make.powerapps interface. We have it here. And in case you don't find even the tables or the solutions, we can click on more and they are going to be here. You can also pin just to make sure it appears in here. Okay. Now we are going to take a look at what you're going to build. I don't have the whole structure, the whole app. I'm going to build as a progress in this lesson, but I already have some drafts. So let's go to Miro and take a look at it. The idea is that we are going to build a system that's used to manage and sell beers that we produce to the bars or the distributors in our region. We are going to use the Dataverse tables to create a Canvas app that's going to be used in the mobile phones of our clients to request products. It's going to be like a shopping cart, so they can see the products, add the shopping carts, and then in the end, once they have all the products selected, they can send the order. This will create a purchase order requests, and the commercial team from our company is going to evaluate that, approve, and then it's going to be delivered. In order to do this, we are going to build a model-driven app. The model-driven app is the second way to build Power Apps, and it has a lot of out-of-the-box features that help us port into Excel, bulk import, bulk editing, filters, views, forms. We are going to learn all of that in this series. So stay tuned, and in the next videos we are going to be creating the tables, but we are not done yet. In order to build that, I've planned a data structure. We have a lot of tables in here. We are going to use some tables that already exist, some like the account and contact. But in these first steps, I'm going to create the products tables, the packaging tables, a table to relate both. I'm going to explain more in the other videos about these relationships, the orders tables, the invoice tables. And then in the future, if we progress with this series, we'll have the deliveries, vehicles, drivers, and so on. To get started, in the next video, we are going to build the product table. So we are going to register the product, adding some information products that we will have in our database. In my case, it's going to be beers, but notice that I didn't put any information related to beer here, so it can any product. You can use this model and build something for your company, for a business. You can learn and you can already apply. So stay tuned, see you in the next video where we are going to create a solution and create our first table.